Hello, now we will see a question on electrostatics asked in board exam, Delhi board 2014, set 1, question 10. It is a question on how to find electric flux. You are given a square of side 10 centimeter. The square initially is placed such that its area is in the YOZ plane, parallel to YOZ plane, but electric field is along X axis. Find the flux. Second case is slightly moving the plane such that the plane of the square is moving in such that, or is rotating in such that it makes an angle of 30 degree with X axis. You want to find out the electric flux in both cases. First case, see, electric field value is given 5 into 10 power 3 I cap Newton per coulomb. So the electric field is along X axis or parallel to the X axis, and there is a square having a side 10 centimeter. We will convert into meter, or area we will convert into meter squared when we do the sum. And you have to find out the electric flux. We know the formula for electric flux phi E as E dot A is an electric flux. For uniform electric field, E dot A, it's a dot product. Electric flux is a scalar. Okay. So now you take this case. Because area vector has a direction perpendicular to the plane of the area. Perpendicular to the plane of the area. Therefore, area vector will also be like this. Electric field is also like this, along X axis or parallel to X axis. Therefore, in the first case, electric flux is EA cos theta. E dot A on expanding gives you EA cos theta. Electric field magnitude 5 into 10 power 3. Area 100 into 10 to the power of minus 4. 1 centimeter 10 power minus 2 meter, 1 centimeter squared 10 power minus 4 meter squared. So multiply it by 10 power minus 4. Cos 0, because the plane of the square is in YOZ or parallel to YOZ plane. So it will have an area vector parallel to X axis. So cos 0. That is, angle between area vector and the electric field is 0 degree. This you simplify, 5, this will be 100 here, cos 0 is 1, so 10 power minus 4, this is 500 into 10 to the power of minus 1, so 50 magnitude. Unit, how do you put? Unit is unit of electric field multiplied by unit of area. So unit of electric flux, Newton per coulomb for the electric field, multiplied by unit of area, which is meter squared. So Newton meter squared per coulomb, the unit. In the second case, plane makes 30 degree with X axis. Plane makes 30 degree with X axis. Okay. So how do you do that? This is a common mistake. You don't put 30 degree in the formula. In place of theta, if you put 30 degree, it would be wrong. We will see why. So what happens in this case, suppose if this is the plane of the area, plane of the area of the square, let's say this is X axis, the plane makes 30 degree with X axis. So perpendicular to the plane will make 60 degree. This is the direction of area vector. This is the direction of electric field. Plane makes 30 degree with X axis. So perpendicular will make 60 degree with the X axis. But electric field is along X axis. So now the angle between the area vector and the electric field is 60 degree, not 30. So you substitute here, phi is equal to E, which is 5 into 10 power 3. The area 100 into 10 power minus 4, simply 10 power minus 2. cos 60 degrees. So this would be 50, cos 60 will be half, so 25 Newton meter squared per coulomb. So you will have to be very careful whenever you do sums in flux, the theta you will have to put properly. Understood that? Thank you.